Is the universe infinite? Does it have an edge? And if so, what would you see if you went there? Today, we know that the universe had a beginning 14 billion years ago and that it's been expanding ever since. But something that's expanding should also have an edge, right? Well, it sort of does. Information can't travel faster than light. That means that we can only see parts of the universe whose light has had time to reach us in the last 14 billion years. When we look outwards, what we see is a sphere centered on us, the observable universe. But it gets a tad more complicated. Because the universe has been expanding, we know that the most faraway things whose light we can see are actually 45 billion light years from us right now. So the observable universe is a sphere with a radius of 45 billion light years. It contains around 200 billion galaxies, each with hundreds of billions of stars. So, for us, there is an edge. We're looking at the past until there is just no past left. This edge is really more like an edge in time and, in a sense, meaningless. The real universe is for sure bigger than what we can see. But how much? There are two options. Either the universe is really big but finite, or it's truly infinite. A finite universe means that if you want to fill it with ice cream, you can do it. You need a lot of ice cream, but it is a finite amount. But that leads to a weird problem. Such a universe should have an edge, a cosmic wall where space ends. And if there's an edge, there should be something outside that edge. But the universe, by definition, is all there is. So how could there be stuff outside all there is? Does the idea of something outside of everything even make sense? Except, of course, there is a physics hack. You can have a universe that has no border, but that still could be filled with a finite amount of ice cream. What if the universe is truly finite? Imagine an orange and a really tiny ant. The ant can only see a small piece of the skin, just as you can only see a small chunk of the universe. But if the ant starts walking, it will eventually walk around the whole orange and be back to its starting point. So the skin of an orange is not infinite, but it doesn't have a border. The universe is not like the skin of an orange, but it could be very similar. Instead of a sphere, it could be a hypersphere, where 3D space is curled on itself. Which is impossible for your brain to visualize, unfortunately. But the point is, no borders, no outside of the hypersphere. From our human ant perspective, our whole 3D space is like the peel of the orange. If you were aboard a spaceship flying in a straight line, you would eventually come back to Earth. How does any of this make sense? The actual physics is hard, so we have to simplify and lie a bit here. But in a nutshell, it all boils down to gravity. The way it works is that mass creates gravity by bending space-time. This bending is the strongest where the mass is, but sort of stretches on forever, like a very mild tension in the fabric of space-time itself. This could bend the whole universe in a way where it bends back on itself, which then makes the hypersphere. If you find this confusing, we're with you. If the universe happens to be a hypersphere, how could we find out how big it is? On Earth, we can see things disappear below the horizon, and that helps us calculate how big the Earth is. Scientists tried to find some sort of universe horizon that would reveal the scale of the cosmic sphere, but didn't see anything. Which means that if the universe is a hypersphere, it needs to be so big that from our perspective, it looks like we're living on a flat surface. For this to make sense, a hyperspherical universe should be at least 1,000 times bigger than our observable part. It could be a trillion times bigger for all we know, but not smaller than that. Some scientists thought all of this is way too straightforward and came up with a wilder option. The universe could be like the frosting of a donut. A hyperdonut, also impossible to visualize for your brain. This too means that if you travel in a straight line, you'd get back to where you started, but with fun complications. In a hyperdonut universe, there's not the same amount of stuff in every direction. If two spaceships fly in different directions, one could get back to the start way earlier. This also means that light from faraway galaxies would do fun and confusing stuff in a sort of cosmic hall of mirrors effect. We could see faraway things in two places, but not just that, we would see it in different moments in time. Because its light would have taken much longer to travel in one direction than the other. You could see a star being born in front of you, and see that same star die on the opposite side of the sky. How big would such a hyperdonut universe be? Well, because of its strange geometry, actually this is kind of the smallest possible universe, potentially just a few times bigger than the observable universe. But it could also be way, way bigger. We don't know. Okay, so much for finite universes. But what if it's truly infinite and space goes on forever? What would that be like? What if the universe is truly infinite? Actually, the cosmological model used by most scientists describes an infinite universe. We mostly use it to calculate what happens inside our observable chunk, but if taken literally, it predicts an infinite universe. An infinite universe goes on, well, forever, with no border anywhere, also impossible to visualize. Wherever you look, you'll find more and more stuff in every possible direction. This kind of breaks our brain a bit for a few reasons. First of all, if the universe is infinite, is it also eternal and has been there forever? Was there a time when there was nothing everywhere, and then there was something everywhere? Well, we don't know, but we have a lot of evidence for the Big Bang, so it really seems like the universe started at some point in the past. But wait, since the Big Bang, the universe has been expanding. How can an infinite thing that's everywhere become even bigger? Cosmic expansion just means that the distance between galaxies is growing with time. Even an infinite space can become bigger. Welcome to the paradoxes of infinity. Infinity gets much weirder though. As you travel with your spaceship in a straight line, you find new galaxies, stars and planets, new wonders, new weird stuff, probably new aliens and new life forms stranger than you could ever imagine. But after a long time, you might find the most special thing in the universe. Yourself. An exact copy of you watching this video right now. How can that be? Well, everything in existence is made of a finite amount of different particles. And a finite number of different particles can only be combined in a finite number of ways. That number may be so large that it feels like infinity to our brains, but it's not really. If you have finite options to build things, but infinite space that is full of things in all directions forever, then it makes sense that by pure chance, there will likely be repetition. Although, just because something is possible, doesn't mean it will actually happen. Maybe the universe goes on forever, but only the boring stuff repeats itself endlessly. Maybe there is really only one you. But if the laws of physics are the same everywhere, then far, far away, gas could have given birth to stars and planets where primitive genetic information could emerge from chemistry, which might have ended up in cells and animals that evolved in really unlikely ways, and eventually apes that learn how to create online videos. It happened at least once, so the chance is not zero. Even if the chance of there being an exact copy of you watching this video right now is almost zero is still a huge number in an infinite universe. Unfortunately, you'll never meet, because almost zero still means the chance is incredibly small. Earth, as it exists right now, is so unlikely, you'd have to travel incredibly far to find a second identical Earth. Some 10 to the 10 to the 29, a 1 followed by 100 octillion zeros, times the size of the observable universe, so far that it kind of means forever far away. Still, in a truly infinite universe, every combination of particles could reasonably not just occur only once, but an infinite number of times. It's time to stop now. While these scenarios are possible on paper, we've entered science philosophy here. Currently, none of these ideas are testable or provable. If the universe is infinite, we will never know. The reality is, for us, the universe is finite and has an edge. And we can see the edge in time. Everything we can interact with is within the observable universe, and most likely, this will stay true forever. Even if this finite universe feels small to you, it's more than big enough to fulfill all the dreams that we and our descendants can ever come up with, infinitely enough for all of us. While we can't be sure whether the universe is infinite, many fascinating questions do have definitive answers in science, maths, and technology. And you can learn all about them on brilliant.org. Brilliant will make you a better thinker and problem solver, with thousands of hands-on lessons on just about anything you may be curious about. They recently launched a whole new suite of data courses that use real data to tell powerful stories while training your brain to see trends through the chaos of truly massive datasets. You'll answer practical questions like how to maximize revenue hosting on Airbnb, using the same analysis techniques that scientists use to explore the distribution of galaxies and unravel the mysteries of the cosmos, a foundation that can take your understanding to astronomical heights. We've also partnered with Brilliant to create a series of lessons to take your scientific knowledge to the next level. These lessons let you further explore the topics in our most popular videos, from rabies and mammalian metabolism to climate science and supernovae. Each lesson on Brilliant is interactive, like our one-on-one version of a Kurzgesagt video. And you can get started whenever, wherever, right from whatever device you'd like. To get hands-on with Kurzgesagt lessons and explore everything Brilliant has to offer, you can start your free 30-day trial by signing up at brilliant.org/nutshell. There's even an extra perk for Kurzgesagt viewers. The first 200 people to use the link get 20% off an annual membership once their trial ends.